Hey, what's up guys, it's Kaustubhia back with another video. And guys, in this video, as per the title, we will be taking a look at the Evolution X 4.5. So this is the update to the previous Evolution X 4.4, and I will be telling you all the details about this latest build of this ROM. And make sure you guys hit that red subscribe button down below, and make sure you also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. With that being said, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. This is the Evolution X 4.5, and this is the upgrade to the previous Evolution X 4.4. So I'll just quickly go into the about info here. And as you guys can see, firstly we get this cool blue Evolution X logo, which looks really cool. Then we get the Android version, that is Android 10. Coming to the Evolution X version here, it is given Evolution X version 4.5. So that is the latest build of this ROM. Security patch level has also been upgraded from the previous build. Now we get 5th July 2020. That is the latest security patch. Google Play System update is of 1st September 2019. So that's old. Then kernel version is 3.18.124 Nitrogen. So this is a Nitrogen OS based kernel. That's what I think. Then build date is Saturday, July 18. So that's the latest build of this ROM. Second thing, after the ROM info, we will be taking a look at the display and the ROM customizations. So I will just go into display right here, and we get all the basic options like brightness, dark theme, night light. All of them are pretty explanatory. Live display is something which has been added. So this color profiles is the new addition to this Evolution X 4.5. Then other than that, all the basic options are present. You can customize the style, ambient clock, wallpaper, everything is there present. Lock screen timeout is also something newly added. So you can also time out the lock screen now. So that's a nice thing. Then yeah, so that's for the basic settings, and lock screen customizations are also there. So you can skip the lock screen, and all of them are pretty explanatory. Always on display is present. Then yeah, so those are all the options in normal display. Here we get a separate tab which is called the Evolver tab, and here we see we get tons of customizations from themes, status bar, notifications, quick settings, power menu, then gestures, lock screen, navigation, animations, and miscellaneous. Coming to the third thing guys, is some of the issues that I faced with this ROM. So firstly is with the alert slider issue. So the alert slider right now is on the bottom position. I'll just quickly unlock the phone. So now if it is on vibrate currently, that is to on the lowest mode. If I put it into the center mode, then it goes on DND, and again if I put it on the top, it just stays in DND, and you can't just customize. Now here it should be on a normal profile, but that's not the case. And if you go into the settings also, and if I search for alert slider settings, then settings are simply not there. I don't know why, but you just don't have the settings for alert slider that is so that you can customize. So that's one issue which I faced. Talking about the third issue is with the hotspot guys. Surprisingly, this issue is faced by a lot of people on the forums as well. I checked it. If you go into the hotspot and if you turn it on, and whenever you connect another device to your phone's hotspot, then that device just simply doesn't get any internet access. So that's one issue with the hotspot. Coming to the fourth thing guys, is the stock launcher. We get the Pixel launcher by default, and here if you go into the home settings, then we get all the basic customization options, but not a lot of fancy options are present. So that's something missing which I thought. Then coming to the next thing guys, is that Volt support. So here as you can see, I have the Volt symbol, and many of you guys have been telling me that Volt has not been working on second SIM guys, but you need to know that OnePlus 3T only supports VoLT, 4G LTE basically on the first SIM only. In the second SIM, only 3G will work. So if you have dual SIM configuration, make sure you put your VoLT Geo SIM into the first SIM slot so that Volt will work. The similar Pixel face unlock. So face unlock works absolutely fine. As you guys can see, it works absolutely blazingly fast too with the AnTuTu benchmarks. So benchmark scores were not that great, I should say. Like it is around 196,257. So guys, these scores are less if you compare it with my previous video, that is of Paranoid ROM Quartz 4 ROM. Guys, this is because that Evolution X ROM is tuned more towards battery, like so that you can get more battery life by underclocking the processor. So the processor has been underclocked, so that's why performance is not great, but battery life is like stable enough, I should say, not comparable to the 4.4. Next thing is the camera performance of this ROM, guys. And as always, again, we get the AOSP camera in this ROM, and this is only again a basic camera, so I don't recommend you to use this one. Rather, you can always try out Gcam Mod version 7.3, as I tell you in each and every video. I have, if you want to check out Gcam Mod for 3T, you can check it right in this video here. I have made a video about it. The battery life with this ROM, I used to always tell you guys that battery life is great on Evolution X ROMs, but that's not the case with this latest version, that is Evolution X 4.5. Battery life has been pretty average, I should say. Like, I am getting around 4 hours of SOT on an average whenever I use it heavily, so battery life is not that great. Like, 5 hours was something I was expecting with this one. So guys, finally concluding the video for this Evolution X 4.5, then what I would suggest you is that just don't try out this latest version, that is Evo X 4.5. rather, you can try out Evolution X version 4.4. so I have made a detailed video about that ROM in the card here, you can check it out. So that was one excellent ROM. Like, battery life was really good on that one, as well as the performance was also good enough. So yeah, so that's about it for this ROM video. I hope you guys like this video. If you like it, please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more awesome content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.